Hello everyone, my name is Austin Henderson. I am the information officer at First Fleet, and I recently heard a story about one of our employees, a team member named Eric Long in Portland, Tennessee, who was living out the core values of our organization in just an extremely practical and just heartfelt way. And so I want to share this story with you. As a quick reminder, if you're unfamiliar with First Fleet or you don't know the core values of our organization, they're really pretty straightforward and simple. They are to safely deliver outstanding service, that we are here to empower our people to do the right thing, that relationships will be based on trust, that we will value, care for, and respect everyone, and we will embrace change as a reality of progress. And I heard this story about Mr. Long, and I just thought, man, it makes my heart proud to know that I'm a part of this family, that I'm a part of this organization, and that it's really a group of people who are trying to do the right thing. They're trying to take care of people out there, and I hope this story from Eric is inspiring to you. And Eric, I'm proud to be on the team with you.
So we're excited. We're down here today at Ronald McDonald House. Our driver, Eric Long, his wife, Bridget, 5-year employee out of Portland, Tennessee. We have a neat story about quilting. I know you're the quilting trucker.
Yep. You know, I go on the road and I get on the CB. I make Marine Corps quilts and Army quilts. I sell on the road. We get stuck so many places. Curfew stores, we got to wait. Back calls, we got to wait. So when I get, they tell me it's going to be a couple hours. I'm like, okay, don't rush. I'm not in a hurry. And I set up my table and I start sewing. I lay everything out on my bed. I sit right here, the sewing machine's in front of me. I got this space over here, that's where I do my ironing. And I got this space over here where I lay out my pieces so I can stay organized. And then I just start sewing.
Well, and you've taken that time and used it for a better purpose than looking at it.
I would say it keeps him out of trouble.
It does. So where we are today, we're down at Ronald McDonald House in Nashville.
And Eric said, you know, I have all these quilts. Who do we give them to? Because right now our guild isn't meeting. Because,
right.
You know, we give a lot to them. And he's like, well, what about Ronald McDonald House? And I said, well, I'm sure they'd be happy to get them.
So absolutely.
That's how that came about.
And they've got a need down here. And it's like I told the lady, look, you know, when these people leave, let them take the quilt with them. So now the back of my truck is empty.